Hi, I'm Kate Woodworth, and I work in the reference department at the library. The book I'm reviewing is Becoming by Michelle Obama. I listened to this one in audio format, actually, which is read by the author. I found her to be an enjoyable narrator, and I think it really added to the story to hear things in her own voice. She tells the story of her life growing up in Chicago, meeting Barack, and eventually living in the White House. It was fascinating to hear about the inner workings of the day-to-day life of the White House, and it's always interesting to see the personal side of a prominent public figure. If you enjoy autobiographies or books about recent events, I think you'll enjoy this one.
Hi, my name is Kendra, and I work in the Youth Services Department of the Kingsport Public Library. I want to tell you a little bit about this book that I enjoyed, and I hope you do too, called Would Like to Meet. It is a very funny book by Rachel Winters. Let me ask you a question. Do you think you can fall in love like they do in the movies? Has someone sweep you off your feet and live happily ever after? Well, meet Evie Summers, and it is her job to find out that exact very thing. Because if she can't convince someone that she can fall in love like they do in the movies, she'll lose her job. Well, who is this mysterious person? Meet Ezra Chester. He is the biggest, baddest, most arrogant movie star around. And Evie has to convince him she can get someone to fall in love with her, just like that. And it's not all fun and games. First couple attempts, she spills coffee all over herself, and then she runs into somebody, and it's just a big mess. And all the while, Ezra is there, pushing her on. Can she convince Ezra that you can find love just by meeting someone in the movies? Then you throw in an adorable daughter with her dad that she always meets every week at the coffee shop. Should she end up with them? Or will she fall for Ezra, who is really just not nice? I don't know. Or will Evie just give up on love altogether and say forget it to all of them? Even though this is classified as a romance, I would call it a romantic comedy because it has very funny moments in it. And I think you might enjoy it too. And you can get this book online through our Reads program, an audio or ebook, and it is called Would Like to Meet. So I hope you enjoy it as much as I did.
I'm Emily. I work in the reference department. Today I am reviewing A Long Way to a Small Angry Planet by Becky Chambers. It is the first book in the Wayfarer series. The books are connected, but they don't have to be read in order. I would suggest you read them in order, but you don't have to. This is a science fiction space opera novel. The crew of the Wayfarer spaceship has been hired to create a space superhighway to a remote corner of the galaxy. They do this by wormholing through the fabric of space itself. A very dangerous, but very lucrative job. While the plot is about this journey, the novel itself is actually about the members of the crew. There's Ashby the captain, Sissix the pilot, who is a lizard-like alien species, Kizzy and Jinx, the kooky engineers, Dr. Chef, the ship's doctor and chef, who's also another alien that's difficult to describe, Corbin the algaeist, who's cranky, Lovey, the ship's AI, Ohan, the navigator, who is a Synot pair, which is a very complicated alien, and Rosemary, the new member of the crew. I would compare this book to the TV show Firefly. It explores each crew member's life and what it means to be a person, to love, to hope, and most of all, family is what you make it. I highly recommend this book and this series, and I hope you'll check it out.